In America, economics is a split, almost a schizophrenic kind of pursuit. And let me explain. On the one hand, there are the departments of economics in colleges and universities across America. But side by side with them is an entire other establishment that also teaches economics. You don't have that in other disciplines. There aren't two history departments and or two anthropology departments or two philosophy. So what is this? I looked into this. It's because there are two separate functions performed by the economics departments and then by the other ones. And the other ones are called business schools and business departments. In fact, in most universities, in all those I've been at, the economics department is in one set of buildings, and across the campus in another is the business school. And there's actually tension in the university about who teaches the basic courses to students that they're required to take and so on. Here's what I discovered. The job of economics, to be blunt but honest, is to rationalize, justify, and celebrate the system, to develop abstract theories of how economics works, to make it all look like it's a stable equilibrium that meets people's needs in an optimal way. These kinds of words are used. But that's useless to people who want to learn how to run a business because it's a fantasy. So they are shunted someplace else. If you want to learn about marketing or promotion or advertising or administration or personnel, go over there. Those people teach you how the economy actually works and how you'll have to make decisions if you're going to run a business. Over there, you learn about how beautiful it all is when you think abstractly about its basic principles.
The invisible hand, the market.
All of that. So for me, I began to realize, okay, I'm an economist, I'm in that one, but I want to understand how the real economy works. And then I discovered that I needed to re-educate myself. I had to go learn things that I was never assigned to read.
After Harvard, after Stanford, and after Yale?
It actually happened while I was there. I was already, there were a few
professors.
Oh,
they do produce heretics.
Yes, you know, but you know, capitalism, I like to say to people, capitalism, like all systems, when it comes into being, is born a few hundred years ago in Europe and spreads around the world, like other systems before it. It has always produced those who admire and celebrate it and those who are critical of it. I used to say to my students, if you want to understand the family lives down the street, suppose there's mama, papa, two children, and one of the children thinks it's the greatest family there ever was, and the other one is quite critical. If you want to understand the family, do you choose only one child to interview, or do you think it might be wise to interview both of them? For me, I began to interview the critics of capitalism because I thought, let's see what they have to say. And that, for me, opened an immense door of critical insights that I found invaluable, and I've never forgiven my teachers for not having exposed me to that.